Hello there, my fellow mushrooms obsessed with DACA, and welcome to another lore video concerning our green friends. Since I couldn't ignore this whole Orktober business, I thought to add at least a little contribution to the Ork love being spread all around. And what better way to achieve this than by talking about an Orky topic that I never expanded on before, aka the Ork Freebooterz. I would also like to apologize for the thinning of Ork videos more recently, but unfortunately there isn't a huge amount of lore left to cover, so the Ork videos I will be making from now on will probably be a bit more sparse. I am your host, for today the green-skinned narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? A freebooter is a piratical orc existing on the fringe of orc culture. Freebooters are bandits and sellswords belonging to no specific tribe or clan, but who will work for any clan or against any other if the price is right. Freebooters are orc warbands composed of an amalgam of orc mobs from several different warbands of orcs who have separated themselves from their former clan by choice or exile. Some of these orcs are fugitives, eccentrics, and the remnants of shattered greenskin tribes or clans, so it is hardly surprising that many freebooters have very treacherous and unpleasant characters even by orc standards. Following the ravages of war or some other disastrous disruption of their life, some orcs abandon what is left of their tribe and join one of these roving bands. Most freebooter mobs hire themselves out as mercenaries, or they can be persuaded to join in a battle with promises of loot. Among the freebooters are a handful of unstable individuals who are particularly dangerous and aggressive. These orcs wander off and tend to form their own small, roving bands of pirates and corsairs. Naturally, they are eager for adventure, combat and booty, and are quite happy to tag along with other orc tribes, or WAs, as mercenaries. Forsaking their former clan's distinctive apparel, freebooters wear styles of dress intended to emphasize their mercenary status, decorating themselves in flamboyant clothing and piercings such as ear and nose rings. Having long abandoned any tribal or clan loyalty, they have adopted highly personalized insignia in place of their former clan symbol. Some of these orcs prefer to remain anonymous. Some want to forget, some want to start a new life, but most have simply forgotten who they were. Often they will employ what the Imperium has named the Jolly Orc Skull and Crossbones icon, a universal symbol for all freebooters. These mercenary orcs are known to use this sigil to adorn their banners, clothes, and vehicles. Freebooters are also recognized by the ragtag appearance of their orc bionics, due to their lack of access to pain boys or mech boys. Their injuries are often superficially treated, thus many freebooters have peg legs, hooks for hands, and even eye patches. As a result, they roam the universe in small, often dilapidated orc spacecraft, and hide out in isolated planets or large asteroids. The band is usually led by a hardened war boss who prefers the title of Captain. These individuals are the greatest, strongest, and most cunning cutthroats the orcs have within these mercenary warbands. They dress even more flamboyantly than their fellow orc freebooters, often sporting large tricorn hats and thick greatcoats which can conceal many weapons. There are those who would claim that the orcs are not the greatest of spacefaring races, that their starships and weapons are unreliable constructions of scrap and salvaged spare parts. There are others, however, who point to the fact that the orcs can be encountered in every corner of the galaxy, and the supposed limitations of their technology have not held them back from being some of the most feared pirates in the galaxy. Their ships are massively armed and loaded with orcs eager for a fight, and an orc's natural love of violence and acquisition makes him a terror to other spacefaring races. The orc freebooters want more of everything, more weapons to grow stronger, more salvage to build ships and war machines, and more wealth for prestige among their kind. While many items captured in raids are of little use to the orcs, such plunder is highly valued by other races who fight and die to protect it. Thus, the value lies in the opportunity for battle, and no proper orcs shirks away from a good fight. Orcs rarely organize above the level of a single ship. However, small fleets can form around a particularly charismatic or successful orc captain. To the mind of an orc freebooter, there are two things which are the most important: battle lust and greed. In the Coronis Expanse, orcs are usually encountered in small raiding ships, roughly the same size as an Imperial escort vessel. However, the size of an orc starship is deceptive. Invariably, the ship is crammed with a green tide of orcs, which ensures that any boarding action is likely to go only one way. An attack by orc freebooters tends to be brutal and direct, with the orc ships rushing headlong towards the enemy, firing every gun they have, before ramming and boarding their victim. The directness of an orc freebooter attack does not mean, however, that a captain can lack cunning. Orcs often lurk in asteroid fields on the edges of a system where they cannot be seen by the sensors of a passing ship. Ambushes on convoys of supply ships from this kind of hidden position are very common, and even attacks on small fleets or warships are not unheard of. Should an orc freebooter captain feel the need for bigger prey, the crew may even descend on an inhabited world or space station, loot it and burn it, and withdraw to their ships and the protection of a debris field. If, however, the orcs of a freebooter's fleet are really spoiling for a fight, they are likely to brutalize a world or void station and just wait and see who comes to check it out. There are, actually, a lot more freebooter types than you'd imagine. And they include the average freebooter. Freebooters are the typical orc pirates, akin in almost every way to a standard mob of orc boys, give or take a couple of peg legs. The flash gits. Those orc flash gits who acquire too many teeth, even for their fellow gits to stomach, are often exiled from their clan and forced to join a freebooter band. The outcast warboss and retinue. Sometimes orc warbosses get pushed out of their tribe by a new warboss, who does not succeed in killing them. These giant orcs and their retinues of knobs often become the foundations of a new freebooter's band. The renegade mechboy. Some freebooter bands are made up of mechboys from different tribes, who have gathered together in the pursuit of a common interest in a certain technology. This is true, for instance, of the orc bikers who make up the freebooters band of Wazdaka Gutsmech. The bad doc. Many of the orc pain boys who have performed the infamous but popular squig brain transplant get exiled from their tribe after a few successful operations, and find a new life among the freebooters. Though whether this is an actual advantage or hindrance is very much an issue. The renegade runt herd. Those orc runt herds, who begin to feel for their Gretchen and can no longer stand to see their grots used as cannon fodder, often leave their tribe and become freebooters, such as the infamous Zodgrod Wartsnaga. Renegade speed freaks. Some of the orc speed freaks get exiled from their tribe for particularly destructive feats of vehicular carnage. They inevitably end up among the forces of the freebooters. The Dread Mob. Dread Mobs are those orc pain boys and mech boys who have devoted themselves entirely to the construction of death dreads, and often end up in a freebooter band. The Weird Boy Warphead. Those weird boys who become addicted to their psychic power often eventually become deadly dangers to their tribe, and are forced into exile. Some of these renegade orc psychers have become even demon hosts, which makes them all the more dangerous. However, there are some Ork freebooters who will still take in these Orks simply for the powers they can command. Freebooter Minders. These are particularly large or tough Orks, often used by freebooter bands as bodyguards for the captain, and enforcers of his will among the crew. Wild Ork Outlaws. Outlaws are feral Orks whose only contact with the more advanced Ork culture has been with the freebooter bands, whom they often join only to see the universe. Ork Mutants. Some Orks develop mutations when exposed to the power of chaos or other environmental mutagens, just like mutants or any other intelligent race. These greenskins are then shunned by their own clan, just as other mutants are, though they are sometimes accepted by the freebooters. Chaos Renegade Ork Warband. The Orks are very rarely corrupted by chaos, but some of the more vicious and militant Ork captains will seek to serve the cause of the Dark Gods in return for power. But for both the ruinous powers and the Orks, such alliances rarely end well. Cornate Stormboys. Some Ork Stormboys discover that the doctrines of the Blood God Khorne are right up their alley. Of course, this means they are usually ejected from their tribe or clan for betraying the worship of the ubiquitous Gork and Mork. Like many other greenskin exiles, they become freebooters. Gretchen Bandits. Some Gretchen can find the freebooter lifestyle very appealing, and come to believe that even they can be as effective at pirating as the bigger greenskins. Sometimes, but only sometimes, they are actually even right. The Ork Gene Stealer Brood. Among the most dangerous freebooters are those groups of Orks who have become infected by the DNA of a Tyranid Gene Stealer and produced the immensely powerful Ork Gene Stealer hybrids from their reproductive spores. These groups can form Orkoid Gene Stealer cults that often act as freebooter pirates, preying on Imperial commercial and passenger shipping to spread the infection. These freebooters can become some of the most dangerous Xenos in the galaxy. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about Ork freebooters for today. There's actually a lot more interesting freebooter stories concerning Ork pirate captains. So, if you guys enjoyed this episode, do let me know and I will make another one focused on exactly that. What are your thoughts on the Ork freebooters? Is an Ork's pirate life for you? Let us know and discuss in the comments below. Was this video informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for more content. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all a very orky day. May Gork and Mork watch over you.